West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada. None of this. Six gunning this, brother running this. Buffalo soldier. Look, it's like I told you. Any damsel that's in distress, be out of that dress when she meet Jim West. Rough neck, so go check the law on the vibe. Watch your step, we'll flex and get a hold of your side. Swallow your pride, don't let your lip react. You don't wanna see my hand where my hip be at. With Artemis from the start of this, running the game. James West, taming the West, so remember the name. Now who you gonna call?
Not the GB.
Now who you gonna call?
Bam, dude, we the best.
Yo.
Episode 35.
Yo.
All I listen to right now are DJ Khaled songs.
Really?
That's it.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's three DJ Khaled songs: the Rihanna one, the Beyonce one, and the Justin Biebs.
All I listen to is Gary Vaynerchuk.
Gary Vaynerchuk.
Vaynerchuk inspires me so fucking good, dude.
He is the foremost thinker of the
one of the foremost thinkers of our generation.
Easily.
You think you're sick and tired of your job? Fucking quit.
Yeah.
And go do what you love.
That's what Gary V says.
There's too many haters out there. Be positive.
Yeah, dude.
This is a great meme. Gary posts sick ass memes all the time. This one, he's pointing at the camera with his signature in the corner, which is fucking tight, dude.
Yeah, that's good.
He's got his own logo. It's like a fucking little squiggle.
It's like a baseball card.
It's fucking sick. It says, "Stop scrolling through your newsfeed right now and work. You've been inspired. Now execute."
You hear that?
Yeah, dude.
Execute right now. Turn around.
Go execute.
Speed on your way to work. Get there.
Get there and fucking execute. Tell your fucking boss. Go in there and be like, "I'm the boss now. I love this job, you faggot." And fucking push him and be more positive than him.
I kind of want to get a job now and just see how hard I can Gary V out in there and just try to execute so hard.
Gary V, I can't wait for this guy to fucking die. God, dude, what a fucking loser. This is a good one. "I'm going to suffocate all your bullshit excuses, so you might as well unfollow me now if that's what you're into."
Damn. But, dude, imagine, I don't know, man. Like, there are so many people who will read that and be like, "Oh, man, dude, I need this kick in the ass. This is good." And
this
like,
is exactly
5 minutes
what I needed,
later,
Gary.
5 minutes later, they're just, like, choking on a Newport outside. Yeah. Like, "I need some more Gary V."
Dude, Gary V, this is probably my favorite meme. It's him sitting there. It's black and white.
Uh-huh.
He's very focused, driven. He's looking out above the skyline, and it says, "It ends up the way it's supposed to be."
Does it say Dash the Spice Girls?
Yeah. It says Dash Holocaust victims.
Yeah.
It was their final quote.
He's got the market cornered on banal platitudes.
Oh, my God,
just fucking
dude.
Anything.
Well, it's this
Give
all...
it 110% and see what happens.
Yeah.
It's like, thanks, Gary.
We were just watching a video before this. He was like, I fucking hate Fridays. If you fucking look forward to the end of the week, if you celebrate the end of your work week, you're fucked up, dude. Your shit's fucked. You need to work harder. Find something that you love. Quit that job and find something you love and do it.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, dude, I'm sure some fucking Mexican washing a car trying to fucking help his four kids is like, "Oh, well, thanks, Gary.
Thanks. I'll pick up one of those tiny guitars and assemble four of my friends and start playing music at a vacation resort."
I'm just going to leave my kids. That's my dream, Gary, is to not have a family.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That'd be sick if like just taking them up on that and just ditching your whole family.
Ditching your family.
Be like, "I'm an amateur porn star now."
Yeah, just tell them to find what they love.
You just go on the internet and just jerk off for other dudes. And you're like, "Thanks, Gary." My life's so much better now.
Well, yeah, if you get the chance, YouTube or get on Facebook and look at Gary Vaynerchuk, I think.
Yeah, Gary Vaynerchuk.
Arguably the biggest douche I've seen in a long time.
Easily. Plus, dude, the people who eat that up, though.
That's also what you got. It's the same people that love, like, Transformers, the movie.
Yeah.
Who
are
same
like,
market.
Dude. Yeah, who, like, get super hype about, like, all that shit.
Yeah.
And they're like, "Dude, it's fucking Ben Affleck's playing in it." It's like, dude, who fucking cares?
Yeah.
When Ninja Turtles came out and people were like, "I don't know, man. Like, I think they fucked up on the new Ninja Turtles." It's like, dude, you're 35.
Yeah, obviously
it's not for you.
Fucked up on it.
You fucked up.
Obviously they fucked up on a CGI Ninja Turtles movie.
It's not for you.
Like, yeah, of course.
It's for fucking 12-year-olds.
That's
shit. That's the weirdest thing to me. And it's celebrated, though. They, like, latch on to, like, childhood entertainment stuff. It's like, man, I fucking love. It's like, all right, you know?
So Fast and Furious is built for those. It's
true.
Gary Vaynerchuk fans also are Vin Diesel. Fuck, I was trying to think of his name.
Yeah.
Vic.
Who's Vic? His name of it?
Vin Diesel is naming it.
Oh, no, fuck, it's, just Vin, it's just Vin Diesel. I watch those movies. I'm like, Vin Diesel.
No, he has a sick Paul ass Walk. Name. Paul Walks, dude, RIP.
No, it actually, dude, I'm listening to that same book. They talk
thank
about,
you for saying listening, listen, dude. Yeah. Thank you. I listen appreciate it. It does book. Sound shitty, but thank you.
Well, either way, dude, they hit me onto the moron class.
Yeah.
Back moron was like a discovery.
Yeah.
There was idiots who were just like, yeah. Like, if you saw someone who was retarded, they would just walk around. You'd be like,
oh, it's
look
a buffoon.
At that idiot. It's yeah, you'd be like, look at that fool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, so there was idiots and fools. But then Goddard, you know the Goddard schools?
Yeah.
So someone named Goddard came up with the term moron, and it was for like sneaky idiots who like looked normal, and then you'd get to know them like, fuck, this guy's retarded.
That's really
and they
great.
Were so scared about it because like you'd have like a servant who might seduce your son, but yeah. It would just turn out she was a moron, and now you don't know until like your son knocked her up, and you're like, fuck, my son knocked
well,
up a
dude,
moron.
Well, dude, you better be worried, because back then a moron could get you killed like real yeah. easy. Like, fuck, dude, I trusted this guy. We're out in the woods
or
now.
Or you just have sick moron kids that like wander off and like eat dirt and die. All I can think about now are moron. I'm like, dude, it's so funny. Everything from that book is so fucked up, but like part of it's always true.
Dude, the idea of discovering a moron, like you're on a canoe, he's in front. Of you, you're going down the river, and he just turns and says something totally retarded, and you're just like, oh fuck, dude.
It's a moron.
Then you're just right over a waterfall. Just, well, God damn it.
Dude, they were trying to pass bills where like they would find moron women because they were trying to like there was a huge moron. That was the thing. Eugenics was huge back then. There was yeah. a department of eugenics where they were trying to stop idiots from breeding. They did like no more yeah. idiots. We can't. We have too many. We don't need any more
we got
idiots.
A lot of idiots.
So they're rounding up chicks, and they were like, all right, these are moron women.
Yeah,
they were calling them feeble minded. They had institutes
I'll
for feeble minded.
I'll tell you what, fucking Gary Vaynerchuk's fucking ancestors escaped.
Exactly,
they slipped through the cracks, dude. Well,
dude, he's making money
now
off
now. That moron's out there posting videos like, yeah. you need to be motivated right now.
Getting all the other ones fired up.
All
I never
other...
thought of it that way, dude. What is a weekend anyway?
That's what happened. Some fucking guy in like coonskin hats, they were on a canoe, and the guy in the front was like, you need to fucking quit what your job is and do what you love. And the guy in the back was like, fuck, I've been duped. It's a fucking moron. My trail, my fucking guide's a moron.
Dude, they had these centers where they would grab women and they would hold them. Like, they would put them in quarantine until they weren't fertile anymore, and then they'd let them back out in society and be like, good. We fucking did it.
Dude.
That's all I can think about is morons.
How you, yeah, I mean.
You're going to talk to people like, fuck, this guy's a moron. And oh, it's yeah. like a sneaky fucking idiot.
It's so funny, man. Just the idea of discovering a moron. Sometimes it takes a while.
I know.
Or, I mean, sometimes it's right away, like hard eye contact when you meet someone. It's like, oh, Jesus Christ, look at this moron fucking staring at me. I ran into a fucking army of morons.
Where?
At fucking Philly's Funniest.
Oh, my God.
I had to host, and you did this last year, so
yeah,
you know
yeah.
exactly what this
yeah.
is, where it's like, that's another, there's some sneaky morons in there. Dude. Like, you'll be talking to a guy, and he'll be like, he'll just say, like, how long have you been doing this? It's like, holy fuck, dude.
Yeah, like
I've been back here with a moron this whole time. Dude, when somebody will fart, a quiet guy will like fart and it'll stink. It'll be like, sorry, that was me.
When you catch them doing their act in the mirror before yeah. they go on, automatic not
moron.
Going through. This is a moron.
Oh, that's a guaranteed loss.
It's a guaranteed L, dude.
Yep.
You'll be backstage. You sit there with like four people who are just like, they're the most nervous people you've ever met. And you sit back and they try to make like casual chat with you. And it's just like the most painful
yeah.
shit.
This is for the comedy contest in Philadelphia that
yeah.
Matthew and I both won.
And they talk themselves up. They're like, yeah, I run a lot of shows out in Ohio. You should come by.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah. Man. It's like, yeah, sure, dude. I'll stop by Cleveland.
Yeah, Midway. We got to get the quarantine centers open, dude.
Yeah, midway through the fucking, you'll be driving down the turnpike. You'll get a text like, show's canceled. It's like, fucking moron, dude. I trusted a moron. I should have known he was a moron. Fuck, now I'm in fucking Bedford, Pennsylvania at a Hoss's.
You gotta watch, dude. They'll
morons
get you.
Will
morons
fucking,
will fucking get you.
They'll fucking trick you. They'll horse feed, dude. They're horse feeders.
Yeah, they'll lie.
Yeah, that's here's a new vocab for all the boys out there,
oh,
dude.
Oh, yeah.
If somebody's feeding you, telling you some lies, dude, horse feeder.
Shoveling hay, dude.
Shoveling hay right into your little dumb horse mouth. And you trot along with them while they're fucking leading you with a little lie, dude. Horse feeders. Lots of feeders out there.
That's all I've been thinking about lately, man.
That's really great.
I've been working lately.
Really?
4 a.m. wake up.
Oh,
like Jocko.
Yeah, fuck, dude.
I wake
I
up
forgot.
At 4 a.m.
Yeah,
take a
man.
Picture. I send it to my brother. Like, what? Jocko takes a picture of his fucking watch.
Oh, shit.
I sent it to my brother this morning at 4:25, and he sent me one back of him driving.
Oh, which one, Billy?
Yeah. Billy drives bull, trash trucks.
So Billy, like... you're a fucking retard. Dude, Billy's a moron. Billy's a moron, dude. He is, man.
He hit me back. I sent him a thing at 4:30, and he hit me back like, there's a lot of small fish. There's always bigger fish in the pond. It was headlights on the road, and I was like, damn, fuck you, dude.
That's sick, though.
That was nice.
I thought you had a one-up on the Bill, man. I could have fucking texted both you boys.
I know. You could have early birded.
I hit you with that fucking 3 a.m.
Early birded. When I get up early, I at least text one person and early bird him. I'm like, what are you doing? You sleeping? I'm up, dude. It's so annoying. It's so annoying.
I get very resentful of you when you do shit like that. Like, I'm actually mad about it. Like, if I'll come upstairs, you'd be like, oh, you just wake up? I'm like, dude, I'll fucking kill you. I've been awake for hours. I was just down there reading and doing push-ups.
I used to call my friend every time that happened. I'd wake up at like 5:30 and call him. He'd be like, what? I'm like, yo, what's up, man? What are you doing, man? I'm up and going. You sleeping? And then he would do it to me, and I'd be like, dude, don't ever fucking call me again. God damn, oh, man. Dude, I'm up 80 feet in the air all day.
Really? What are you doing?
Just breaking rocks.
That'd be sick if you fell to your death.
I think about it all day.
How
all
far? Day, so, like, what are the like? What's the chances? Dead. How hard would it be for you to fall and die?
The lift would have to flip.
Okay.
Or sometimes, you know, I climb up a little bit and get a little acrobatic, but like, I'd have to either slip out of my harness, which, you know, I should tighten it up a little bit, or the lift flips, dead.
What the fuck are you doing?
Working. My father summoned me.
So now you're up on like a cliff.
I'm up on a lift. Rocks? I'm up on a lift, knocking down smokestacks in a industrial park in Claymont.
Oh my god, dude!
5 a.m. till 2 after.
Don't they have fucking Mexicans for this?
No, you can't put Mexicans up that high.
True, Mexicans are very ground forces.
They're land lovers, they are, dude. Some of them will get high.
They'll go underground like the Chilean miners, but yeah, they won't go up. They're not a big up group.
Nah. They're built for like the...
They're like moles. That's why they're built like moles. They all have that same stature.
Some of them will get high. The people who go high are typically Native Americans and Irish people.
Damn, natives.
Dude, you kidding me? They jump off cliffs and do backflips all the time.
Really? That's what Native Americans do?
They love doing that. Did you ever see Pocahontas?
Actually, it's funny you say it. They fought on a cliff in Last of the Mohicans, too. Dude, you're onto something here.
Didn't the one guy fucking ride Geronimo, rode his horse right off a cliff?
Well, that and then the Revenant, but he was raised by Native Americans.
True.
Maybe we're onto something here. A lot of Native American cliff-related...
Native Americans and Irish people will go up high.
Yeah, the Irish people on like the steel girders in New York.
We don't care.
No, we'll get up there.
We'll get up. We'll get it done. But yeah, dude,
I'm fuck heights. Fuck that.
Really?
Yeah, fuck that. No way.
I thrive up in the air.
I would never go up there.
Well, someone's got to stay down and boss around the sexy Mexies, dude.
True. I would be down there telling the lads what to do. I'd be like, all right, we're going to take a break. I'd be the worst fucking boss ever. Like, let's just take a nap.
You guys all putting your hats over your eyes and taking a siesta?
I gotta respect their culture, dude. You do. Lots of fucking siestas. Dude,
they take fucking monster lunch breaks.
Yeah?
I mean, they outwork everyone. You go on a job, the Mexicans just work circles around everyone, and then like 12:30 to 1:45 or 2, they bring like a big crock pot thing, and they all heat up food together, and then they fucking chill on the drywall and put their hats down and
sleep.
They take real siestas.
Oh my god.
But they do like five times the amount.
They're all little short, squat men, and they're all wearing like JNCO jeans and shit. They all have fucking ridiculous lad outfits. Dude, wait, didn't we see a guy at a gas station?
They got all
he's dressed like a fucking lad?
Yeah, they have all the old Arrow. If you guys are wondering where all the Arrow pastel went, the lads have it.
The lads have
paint splattered Arrow pastel.
Bedazzled jeans, dude. They love bedazzled jeans and cowboy boots if they're going out.
Yeah, dude.
The lads will pop on some cowboy boots.
Yeah, when they gotta like get on a Salinas tour bus and like propose to her angry father, they chuck on the cowboy boots.
The lads are the shit, man.
Dude, they're the best.
We want everybody out there to know that we are big fans of the Mexicans.
Oh, I love them, man.
Very big fans. Although they should come to this country legally.
Yeah. They should, but you know,
if they sneak through the cracks, dude, they are very low to the ground people.
Oh, they can get in.
They can fucking mole tunnel right under.
They could scuttle about their way in here, dude.
Oh, yeah. It's the natives you got to worry about. Yo. They'll fucking launch right over that wall.
No, they'll fucking ride their horses.
Backflips.
They'll come right off the cliff.
Yep.
Dude, I was at work today, and I'm like, I'm up in the air, and I'm like 80 feet up, and like I thought about it. I was like, dude, I could get a GoPro and make one of those videos where I stand on the edge and like.
Oh, man. You should do it.
I was laughing.
It would just
at,
be
like,
funny if
people
you did.
Getting caught doing that and be like halfway through, it's like, what the fuck? Get the fuck down. You're like, hold on a second.
Yeah.
I'm making a cool, dangerous video.
Like and subscribe, dude. Fucking Gary Vaynerchuk would come out and be like, dude, he's doing what he loves. Fuck
that's
that.
That's such a sick idea for a YouTube video. Like, this guy's up high as fuck.
I've watched a bunch of those.
Yeah, but you watch can also guys, be on a harness.
Those radio tower guys?
Yeah.
Those, like, cell towers and shit?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? Those videos are fucking terrifying.
Yeah.
That's fucking unbelievable. The guys that, like, change a light bulb at the top of that.
I'm not about that.
Ooh.
I got a GoPro my day.
I'll GoPro
my
fucking...
Just be like my uncle saying racist shit all day, and I'm, like, covering the camera, like, uncle, shut up.
Oh, boy. Oh, I gotta make a couple amendments, because our history episode last night, I got a lot of complaints about that.
Who?
A lot of fucking dorks on the internet.
What's up with
fucking
my hater? What's up with my one hater from
one
the
hater?
Main board?
Yeah. His name's Dairy Queen.
Fuck that dude.
He's a fucking bitch.
Let's see you come up in the lift with me, dude.
Yeah, come
fucking
up in the lift.
Throw
dude.
Your ass
Toss
out of there.
Your fucking liberal ass out. He's a fucking lib, dude.
Of course he
He's
is.
He's a
dude.
Hardcore lib.
Who else would be hating?
He's a fucking hater, dude.
Fuck him.
That sucks that that's what the liberals have been relegated to. Just pure fucking haters.
Bitch haters.
Bitch ass cuck fucking haters.
I thought about him today when I was up high.
You thought about
I thought about my I thought about my hair? Anti fan. I was like, man, fuck that guy.
That's what I was saying to them on there. I was like, dude, if one person says a word about me for a week, I'm just like, what the fuck, dude? Fuck this.
I was laughing. I was like, man, fuck that guy. I'd like to see him come up here. I'm all day up there, just next to my brother, dude.
The fuck are you gonna do about it, Dairy Queen?
I'm next to my brother on my father's orders, dude, risking my life.
That's fucking.
And that guy's like, I don't know, I don't really like their show.
Actually, illegal immigration is good. I believe in illegal things because I'm dope.
That is weird, though, how you can't even talk about it. If you were like, we need to tighten our borders, it's racist. It's dude, it's good.
It's like, no, just make them come over legal. Now, what we should do is streamline how easy it is to do it legally. I think that's the big issue, is because it takes forever to do it legally. So it's like a 5-year fucking wait, and you're from Guatemala, dude. You're just trying to lad out. You're just trying to go buy a fucking pair of cowboy boots,
I mean,
some JNCOs.
It's one of those things where I'm like, I don't give a fuck because it doesn't right now affect me at all.
No, of course.
But like if I was like everyone I know in my town was out of a job, I'd be like, all right, man, this is fucking bullshit.
Yeah, true. If you're some bitch boy like fucking Dairy Queen who's probably some fucking office turd and...
Yeah. They're coming for you too, man.
Yeah, dude. Wait till the lads. Automate. Yeah, once those lads learn how to build robots and shit.
Give them that. When they get their hands on the fucking Excel spreadsheet, dude, good luck.
Yep.
Once they
fucking figure out the Excel sheet,
they'll be having
done.
Those fucking stubby. All you hear is stubby fingers, like
fucking
hammering.
Burrito fingers, dude. Plowing away at the Excel. Doing combos you never even thought of, dude.
That is funny, though, because I never gave a fuck about immigration, but I also, It's like, well, fucking, we shouldn't even have borders. It's like, all right, we'll unlock your door, take your door off the hinge, and it's
Well, there's that argument. I don't believe in that. Like, when people are like, we should let Syrians in, it's like, all right, we'll fucking let them into your house. It's like, well, no, obviously, fuck that. But when you're sitting here saying open borders or whatever, or like criticizing someone who's like, well, maybe they should come into the country legally.
Yeah.
It's like, what's wrong with saying that? There's nothing wrong with saying that. It doesn't make you racist.
There's people who will say, though, like, I don't even think we should have, like, a border.
Well, yeah, there's people that'll...
It's like, all right, unlock your door.
Yeah, true.
Like, you need borders. You have your houses walled off. Why? Because you don't want some fucking dude to roll in there.
Yeah. You don't want a lad coming in.
You don't know. Yeah, you don't want
a lad. A bad lad, dude. You got to watch out for the bad lad. Most of them are very good, but you got to watch out for the bad lads.
The bad ones are very bad. That's the thing.
Very bad, dude.
They get a snake tattoo. They get a snake tattoo, and they come over here and they stab and rape.
Next thing you know, you're getting beheaded.
It's 1 out of 100.
One out of 100.
That 100th. That 100th one is a Malecito, dude.
Yeah, he's a fucking bad hombre, dude.
Dude, it's a bad hombre.
We'll fucking cut your dick off. Yeah.
We'll put your head on a turtle, dude, and send it across the border.
Right on top of a tortuga, you fucking bitch, Dairy Queen.
That is a funny element of the cartels about, like, if you really went over there, just a bunch of, like, 5'4 dudes over there. Like,
yeah,
no, we must
fucking,
take
them. Yeah, you ever see a picture of El Chapo? Like, what a fucking chubby little bitch, dude.
He just looks like a drywall foreman.
He looks like Mario, dude. That's why he keeps escaping out of the pipes in prisons, dude. That's how he gets down the pipe. It just goes, quick, quick, quick. He's crawling underneath the tunnels like, do-do-do-do-do-do.
He just jumps down the toilet. Oh my god.
That joke has to have been made. That was
no
fucking,
way.
That
dude.
Was a layup, dude.
That was a fucking
once
slam
you see
dunk.
El Chapo and you realize how much he looks like Mario, you'll be like, oh yeah.
Dude, I've never heard that before, and we're on the cutting edge of fucking humor.
We are actually on the forefront of it, but
God damn
it.
Wait till
you see El Chapo. Heck, it's funny. There's a lot of Mexican restaurants called El Chapo.
Of course, dude. Why wouldn't you? That's like Italians do that. They'll be like Godfather's Pizza. And oh, like yeah. Goodfellas. Yeah, yeah. And it's like every Italian.
Goodfellas Pizza. It's like you're a fucking dork from New Jersey. Fucking El Chapo, dude.
Oh, my
God. He looks like Super Mario, dude.
He looks like almost like James Gandolfini.
In that picture, he does. Yeah.
He looks like James Gandolfini mixed with Johnny Depp's friend from Blow from Cuba or Colombia.
You gotta see old ones. You gotta see old or newer pictures of him to think that. But damn, dude, that's sick. Here he is with gay ass Sean Penn.
Holy fuck,
Sean
dude.
Penn like went and did an interview with him or something.
Hey, it looks like he's like owns a car wash.
Yeah, he does. Except he's out there fucking cutting people's heads
fucking,
and dicks
he'll
off.
He'll destroy me, dude.
Yeah. He'll fucking he'll
El Chapo,
flip that little lift, dude.
He'd put my fucking big head
he'll
on
jump on your head.
He might need two tortugas to fucking get my big head on there, dude.
He'll jump on your head and you'll be dead.
He'll squash me.
You'll have to go back into your shell.
I could use him for knocking down those fucking towers, dude. Having him fucking
break those bricks.
Yeah,
dude. Yeah, the lads are wild. Oh, another guy on the main board. Oh, yeah, back to what I was saying.
Oh, yeah.
About some history
inaccuracies.
Well, for one, I said that under Soviet Russia, the death toll was like 20 to 80 million. Yeah, the 80 was a little high there.
Okay.
But still, it's like fucking, it's like 20 to 50 or 60 million, maybe.
Room for error.
Yeah. This is, all right, by the way.
You're going to nitpick about that?
I gave a fucking history talk for an hour, an impromptu talk about history at 2 a.m. while I'm drinking vodka in a basement.
Yeah.
There's going to be some fucking, you know. Some
I mean,
fake news
it's
throughout
like being
that.
Like 7 million Jews died in the Holocaust. Yeah, yeah. And actually, it was like six, and it's like
it was actually 6 to 9 million, perhaps.
It's like, all right, man, come on.
Yeah, but
we're talking theory, dude. We're not facts are for computers, dude. That like look that
true.
Stuff up.
Fuck
like
yeah,
hard
dude.
Numbers.
Hard numbers are for fucking dorks, dude. You're the new Gary Vaynerchuk.
Thank you.
That sounds like
dude,
a meme
I'm very
he
much
make,
like
dude.
Him.
Facts are for computers. I'm an emotional and instinctual entrepreneur.
Take a picture of me, dude, and put it in black and white. Facts are for computers. What a fucking dick.
Another one I said about the socialists, how Nazis, well, it was National Socialism, it was Nazis, but I said that the swastika was originally a Christian cross with a hammer and sickle.
Yeah.
And someone was like, I've never heard that, you made that up. And it was like, well, I just read it in a Kurt Vonnegut book.
Yeah.
That's the only place I've ever seen it, so.
Okay.
Could be, I think that's fake news from old Kurt, but
think Kurt
he would know,
news?
Dude, he was over in Dresden.
Yeah.
He fought.
And it's like
last thing I need is some fucking Nancy boy on the internet telling me he knows more about World War II than Kurt Vonnegut. So suck my dick,
well,
Dairy Queen,
also,
or whoever
that thing
said it.
Come from like an old Egyptian symbol or something.
I forget. It's Hindu or Buddhist or one of those.
Yeah.
I mean, the swastika is cool to draw. So I mean, everybody instinctively have been drawing it.
It's
on
like you
caves.
Know, you draw an S where you make
yeah,
six
yeah, the
lines
S, yes.
And then you connect them and make an S.
Same level of coolness.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That'd have been funny if those dudes just were Nazis.
And then there was some other fucking. Whatever. There was some. We had to go back and
just a little bullshit.
I had to come back and
I'll
edit
make your
those
own fucking podcast. You jerks.
Yeah, exactly. You jerks. You freaking jerks.
You fucking buttheads.
And then a guy today. They're doing a college football review.
Okay.
On the main board. I think this guy said I nominate Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast to do South Carolina.
What about South Carolina?
What do you think about South Carolina football this year?
The Chargers.
Yeah.
What do they call? Who's the South Carolina
Chargers?
What do I think about them? I think their line's looking good. They got a lot of boys up front on the line.
They got a lot of good boys up front. It's
open
the
holes.
Gamecocks.
The Gamecocks.
South Carolina Gamecocks.
Oh, those, yeah, that's a good squad.
Yeah?
Dynasty, some may call it.
What do you think about?
I think they're going all the way.
Do you think they?
I think they're going to take the ball. I think they're going to win all the bowls, dude.
They had a lad quarterback for a while.
They had a lad?
They had a guy named Garcia.
Really?
Yeah.
Sometimes Garcias are like Mexican royalty.
True. Those he wasn't. Dudes, he. Oh, he definitely wasn't a lad. He was a light skin.
Yeah, they're like the swashbuckler class.
There's not
fucking
one lad in any level of football. They're too short and stubby, dude.
You could chuck him a little punter, maybe.
Yeah, there is a kicker. There's
say,
a fucking couple lad kickers.
I know the lads get in there and punt the ball, dude.
So that concludes our our college football preview.
Yeah. So what
South Carolina
does he want
Chargers?
Do
no, he just wants. I. He said a little college football preview.
Oh, you want me to tell what's going on? What's going on with them?
You tell us.
I know they're looking good. They got that new coach coming in.
Yeah, what's
his
name?
You got the one coach. I don't know, gray hair guy, pasty white guy. He's coming in. He's got a visor.
Mm-hmm.
Mean scowl on his face.
Yep.
He's a no bullshit kind of guy.
He is a no bullshit guy.
He's a fucking.
Gamecocks look good. They're bouncing back. They had a rough year last year.
Did they?
Yeah.
Oh, that's right, yeah. And run game back. Was weak.
Run game was a little suspect. Yep. And they're coming back. They're in the SEC. Nice. So they play a lot of tough teams.
That's a tough division.
Florida, Georgia, Alabama, LSU. Yeah. So what do you think? What do you pick their record this year?
Oh, man.
I'm not going to tell you how many games they play because I want to hear you get
28 and 4.
28 and 4. You think they're going to play 32 games this year? Yeah, just a classic 32-game college football season.
32 and 4. The Gamecocks are coming in strong, dude. They're going to win the whole thing.
Perfect. You heard it here, you fucking butt fuckers.
There you go.
The South Carolina Chargers are going to go 28 and 4 this year. All right, let's take a break after the preview, dude.
And we're back.
All right, we're back from the college football preview.
Oh,
and,
man.
We
just crunched some numbers.
Crunched mad numbies. And we're going to talk. In the break, we were talking about morons.
Yeah.
And how funny it is. And there's a Facebook group out there called PA Goes Wild.
Oh, it's Pennsylvania Goes Wild.
Oh, it's not PA Goes Wild. No, it's Pennsylvania Goes Wild. You need to fucking
join.
Look at this fucking thing. Join it if you can. It's, well, I mean, I unfollowed it because after like a week, it wasn't funny to me.
It's
insane. It is fucking moron central. Like, you know the movie Idiocracy?
Yeah.
It's just that.
It is. It literally is.
It's like,
is.
Ow, my balls. Yeah. And people are like, you're hot. I want to fucking jerk off to you.
They're all, so it's just nonstop sex memes. And it'll be like, someone will put a thing like, sex relieves stress. And there's like a guy in like a fucking suit just like holding a naked girl. And that's just yes or no. And there's like 90 dudes like, hell yeah, hell yeah. I fuck all the time. Then there's like guys will come on and be like, ladies, post some selfies. And it's just a bunch of fucking like
morons.
Yeah.
Sad morons. All of them are named Don.
Yeah. It's just a bunch of ladies at a, like, who sit at like a fucking industrial center's desk all day taking selfies in the bathroom being like,
yeah, what do you think? My favorite is when a moron will fucking make fun of the moron lady.
Yeah.
Be like, yo, the bitch is ugly. It's so fucking funny.
Dude, I'm trying to find, there's like all these. There'll be a lady with her legs spread in a bikini, like, what does this picture smell like? Everyone's like, ass, pussy.
Smells like fish. It's crazy. Christ. It's just where all the you remember the retarded guys in your class in school?
Yeah.
It's just where they ended up.
Literally, it's
like in
game
school,
time,
the morons.
Everyone will comment with the last two digits of their mobile number, chat with your match.
It's like a weird online dating for retards.
Yeah. It literally, girls will go on and post a picture of their like butt, and it'll be like 40 guys being like, "Damn, baby, I'd lick your ass all night." It's like, oh yeah,
yeah. And the girls like it, dude. Yeah, the girls are they fucking all in.
They love the attention, dude.
Everyone's so here, a hot chick.
This sums it up. It's like I'm about to, and it's like a, what is that called? Fucking an acronym.
Yeah.
So it's like I'm about to nut, N-U-T, nurture her, understand her, treat her with respect. How often should a woman be sucking her man? How often should a woman be sucking her man's dick a week?
What are some of the answers?
Let's see what kind of wisdom they can bestow
upon
us.
This is retards screaming at
retards. Deidre Riviera, every day, at least twice a day. Yeah, okay?
Yeah, fucking awful.
Let's read what the fuck. Dude, it's so 30 or 40 times at work. That's funny.
Was Deidre a man?
As a man.
Oh, that was
this
a man?
This is all dudes.
Who's like, he needs to get his dick sucked twice a day, every day?
This is a dude who, but yes, that was a man.
A fucking maniac,
the man needs his dick sucked twice a day. Yo. That guy probably does need his dick sucked twice a day.
How many lads do you think fucking stumble in there, dude? I bet lads are in
the
there.
The lads just check out pics. When I work with them, they do. The lads got their hand. I watched the fucking transition. They got their hands on those Cricket mobiles, dude. And when they're not working, they pull up porn on their phones. I'll testify to that.
No, when I was in Spain.
That's fucking true.
I know these are different than lads, but when I was in Spain, a lot of the older, because I was in like a kind of a shitty part of Madrid that was like old.
Yeah.
Like it was geezers and like, or not geezers, but it was like old. It's like third world. Yeah. Not third world, but like, you know what I mean? These are like poor workers in Spain.
Yeah, and they're poor
and
as fuck.
They were so excited. They all had phones, and they all had pictures, and they were all just figuring out memes.
Yeah, it's just pics.
So, like, these guys would show you, they would show memes like that, of, like, sex relieves fucking tension, and a picture of a dude in a suit, and they'd be like, huh? Mira. I'd be like, all right, great, yeah, dude, that's funny.
Dude, I remember they all got Cricket mobiles, dude, and, like, they would just be like, it's just, like, you know when you're, like, fifth grade, and you finally see, like, pics where a chick, like, pops her nipple out? They're like, Mira, and you're looking, you're like, dude.
Dude, I'm like, wait till you guys evolve to cats.
Yeah, check
that. We were at cats like a decade ago, yeah. And that's really funny.
We saw so much porn.
Now we're on to like the worst, that, the dumbest shit on earth.
Dude.
What?
That guy, whatever his name is, like, you should
work. No, that's not real.
40 hours.
The real level of like the internet now is like a hot dog meme.
True.
Or like...
It's nonsense.
A fraud. Dat boy was hilarious. Yeah. Dat boy is gone now, but here come dat boy was like my favorite fucking meme.
Or like I can has dat.
Yeah, I can, like no, cat. I can has cheeseburger is like 2007.
That dude. Was old. Yeah,
that's probably big in Spain right now.
Yo, definitely.
The lads are on fucking dial up right now.
The American lads are gonna stay on like hot picks for a while.
Yeah, the American lads love hot picks.
That dude told that dude. They used to tell me when I worked with these Mexican dudes. They would tell me not to have sex too much because you only get so many nuts, then your dick stops working.
Damn.
They think it's like a number thing.
Well, technically, it is a number.
They're like, don't jerk off and like use them wisely because you only get so many, otherwise your dick stops
technically
working.
Technically, everybody does have a certain number of nuts
True.
At the end of the day. But,
yeah, maybe. You got to use them wisely, dude. These guys are fucking holding their nuts
out. The lads just getting like pictures of like Pamela Anderson right now. Dude. They must be like, holy fuck, dude. They're used to like squat worker sniz.
Yeah.
Back in Guadalajara, some fucking chubby little Mexican.
Man, they got me fired up.
Now you fucking move to
Pam Andy.
Now you're on Pam Andy. You're like, what? This is an alien. Well,
you're going from like Stevie's girlfriend from fucking from Eastbound and Down
to now the next thing you're looking at is like a Cindy Crawford.
Jesus
like, holy
Christ.
Fuck, dude. This is an alien.
That's true. That'd be hard. I'd use all my nuts up if that was the case.
You'd run through those nuts.
Dude.
That's probably why those guys are napping after that crock pot
that's
meal.
That's true, dude. They're probably cracking two up.
Uncork them, dude.
Dude, this one guy, for this, like, how many times should you suck your man's dick a week? This dude just says, what goes around comes around.
True. That's fair. He's talking about, you suck my dick, dude. Yeah. I'll eat your puss.
One guy just said 11.
Oh, man, 11. 11. That was a lad, dude. He was like, you get 11 total dick sucks.
There's 11, 14, and 21 all in a row. And then it's like, as often as he eats my pussy, Jason comes in. I totally agree with you. Pleasure for pleasure. That's the only way. I enjoy eating pussy so we can both expect it daily. These are two morons, dude. They crack the code like, I'll eat your pussy if you suck my dick.
There needs to be a list of there is literally a list. You need to print that list of people that are on that website or on that Facebook page. That's a fucking list of morons.
Oh, dude.
Their faces need to be plastered at every Wawa. Like, watch out for this person, dude.
They should fucking sterilize this
They're
whole group.
Bump into you
they
and just, spill
you
your coffee.
They should sterilize these 23,000. What do broccoli and sex have in common?
What?
If you were forced to have it as a child, you will hate it as an adult.
Oh, shit. That's actually a pretty funny joke.
That's horrible.
Who's that? Anthony Jeselnik? Who wrote that gay shit?
Probably. Damn, dude. That's so fucking funny. Damn, now they're breaking down the horoscope-wise, dude.
Oh, they're getting into horoscopes?
Who's the best in bed?
Sages, dude.
Aquarius, baby.
Aquarius are the best?
Sag, you're the best at oral.
Fuck you, dude. I'm a Sag, dude. I'll fucking eat out everybody. I'll suck anybody's fucking dick.
Dude, next to each one is like different emojis. They have like that side smile of the one. Then like the horned devil for overall freaks.
Overall freaks, yeah. Dude. These are all just fat fucking ugly women working. In like, I'm a freak, baby.
These are like ladies in like super shiny shit you get from Kohl's with like, it looks like a peacock with like sipping like a 40-ounce Dunkin' Donuts being like, I'm a fucking freak.
I'm a bad bitch. Like, I'll fucking eat. You better eat my ass. It's like, no. You shouldn't even be in this restaurant. You should
Jesus
be outside,
Christ.
Tied up like a horse in the Old West.
That's the funniest thing to me is thinking of like a plumber with like his administrative assistant wife just like tying each other up and like eating each other's ass.
No, I meant tied up like a fucking horse. Like, you just lay the rope on a post. This is where these people belong.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we got to get the center for the feeble-minded back. I'm going to open that back up.
Get it going again.
You get the feeble. There's centers for feeble-minded boys. You just fucking, you take them in, you hold them for a while.
Yeah, make sure they're dumb coming.
You snip them.
And release them.
Yep.
No more of them.
Hell yeah.
Unfortunately, that actually would probably be pretty sick.
What?
Eugenics like that. It would probably work in the end. It would just be really evil and horrific in the meantime.
Yeah, to not let people have kids?
Yeah, it's evil.
Yeah, it's really fucking mean.
That's what fucking Hitler did.
It's horrible.
Yeah.
But again, everything I've been listening to has a grain of truth to it.
Well, yeah. I mean, there's just like, a level of
if you get rid of all the morons. But dude, I mean, I think morons are just like random mutations. If you have like six kids, one of them probably is going to be a fucking moron.
You got a lot of morons.
Yeah.
Yeah. Morons are everywhere.
True.
But it's funny to think of sneaky morons that you like. Every once in a while, you'll say shit that I'm just like, holy fuck, dude.
Yeah.
He's mad a fucking secret moron. Remember, I used to make fun of you for that.
Well, I used to smoke a ton of weed, too.
No, but you would, like, occasionally you'd be like, I'd be like, damn it, dude, this is the guy I fucking partnered up with. He's a fucking retard, dude. He's out here fucking climbing on smokestacks and shit.
It's a noble profession.
Yeah, that was a poor example.
No, ever since I, like, really, really cut back on smoking weed, my theories have fucking declined heavily.
Your theories have declined. I noticed that. Yeah, well, early on, I wanted to get this conspiracy theorist guy to come in and debate you.
Yeah.
But you're not even into that shit.
No, I don't care. You stop smoking weed, that shit goes away.
Oh, I was fucking laughing so hard. Me and Christian and the boys were looking at your fucking... Your website, mattmccusker.com,
oh, dude,
and your merch, dude. Gucci tee is the funniest fucking thing.
The Gucci tank top.
Go to mattmccusker.com and check out his fucking merch section, dude. Gucci tee is so sick.
Dude, it's funny because I never check. I mean, I don't think anyone's ever bought anything.
Someone's going to buy some
but
shit
soon. I would never know because I never check it.
So what happens if they buy it?
I have no idea. I have an online marketplace. It should email me and tell me.
Dude.
But I never check it.
I'm sure somebody's tried to buy a Gucci tee.
Dude, that'd be
ooh, that's a good idea for the Patreon.
Set up Gucci tees.
Gucci tees, dude.
Gucci tees are nice. There's just Gucci.
It's a black fucking tank top that says Gucci.
G-O-O-C-H-E-E.
Gucci. And some sort of weird logo. What logo is that?
Just a G.
Yeah, dude.
That's a sick fucking tank.
The weed shirt.
The
unbelievable.
Weed shirt's unreal.
Unfucking
that's tied up from legal issues right now.
Sick glass.
Sick glass. Frosty perp nugs.
Frosty nugs, dude. Aliens.
Yeah. Sativas.
Legends.
Trippy.
Munchies. Yeah. I think I got you all this.
Yeah.
Can you think of another one?
No, just sativas.
Did we cover them all?
Sick ass, frosty,
indicas?
Perp nugs. And I think I just put sativas
just
on
just sativas.
Because perp nugs are generally an indica trait, but.
Oh, nice. Look at that. I don't know anything about that.
That's like me in college football.
Andrew.
Oh my god. We should start doing strain reviews. Do you ever watch those videos?
I'll fucking review a strain right now.
That was the original thing with fucking
ask me about a strain, I'll give it a review.
What do you think about Sour Diesel?
Sour Diesel, I'll tell you what. It makes me incredibly anxious and thinking about my own mortality. And it always makes my skin itch. Go ahead, give me another one.
You never read those on the fucking every, always like, I got highly creative and charged and peaceful.
Really?
Whenever you read the strain reviews, it's like highly creative buzz, mostly cerebral with a nice body letdown.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's mostly like, I thought my heart was beating weird for approximately 2.5 hours.
No, mine review would be every time, like I smoked it right before bed. I ended up thinking about death for a while. My skin itched. I thought about how everyone I loved was going to die. And then I fell asleep and had a nightmare. And then I woke up tired.
Tired and spaced out for the day. That's so fucking funny. That's the truth.
I don't like weed. And then occasionally, I still do it.
Yeah.
I'll still smoke occasionally.
That's funny.
And it's never fucking been good.
See, I love it. I love smoking weed.
I never have a good time.
I also get to the point where, like, if you smoke too much of it, I just feel fucking dumb. I'm like, man, my brain is fucking, there's parts of it that I put on snooze.
Yeah, dude.
And then I stop smoking weed and I get real serious. I've been serious as fuck the last 3 days. I get up at 4 o'clock and just drive right into my job, and I'm like, dum 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 dum. I get real fucking weird.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's cool, but I get super fucking serious.
I'm alright with you being serious.
I'm fucking not fucking around right now.
You seem like you're fucking around, dude.
I'm not fucking around.
You had better not be.
I get super fucking serious.
So
I'm on a serious. That's the best thing, dude.
What?
We've talked about it before.
What?
What dudes who aren't funny have to do to get pussy.
Mm.
Now, if you're super fucking serious,
just got
dude.
My haircut in that place today.
Yeah, you're dealing with them.
It's the fucking ultimate. There's a place called I'm Sergio in Contra.
First of all, what a fucking
I know.
The guy's
cunt
definitely named
name.
Sergio too.
It's definitely a fucking huge douche named Sergio.
Silk shirt, no doubt.
I think I saw him today.
Did
I
you?
Think. I was off to a pretty rough start, dude. Every time I go in there, I always think it's a good idea to go in there, and it's so uncomfortable.
Yeah, man.
It's like so this whole. Barbershop is dedicated to the fact that it's hot chicks.
Dude.
So it's like a salon for men, and it's all hot chicks. And so today I walked in, and they give you like beer and stuff.
Yeah.
She's like, do you want anything to drink? And I was like, no, I'm okay, but I do have to use the bathroom. So I just walked in and I opened the door and one of the girls was in there. I like hit her with the door.
Bonus?
She didn't say anything. I just hit her with the door. I didn't see anything. She was like, I don't know what the fuck she was up to. She was standing away from the toilet, but like still hunched over. I think it might have been some sort of feminine product.
Pregnancy thing. Test, maybe.
I have no idea what was going on. No, she wasn't by the toilet.
You pee on the floor.
No, I don't think so she's peeing on the floor.
They probably just pee on the stick right
anyway,
on the floor.
Anyway, so I'm off to a hot start. I'm in there in my fucking gym shorts, sneakers.
You sexually assaulted a woman.
Got
go
a
ahead.
Sick mustache.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The listeners don't know about how nice my mustache is right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
A lot of people are talking about this mustache. There's a big buzz going around. Anyway. So I go in there, hit her with the door, but then I sat there and listened to this guy, and somehow I always get the ugly of the group.
Yeah.
There's always just one incredible lady.
Yeah. You get the one lame.
I get the fucking.
You get the lame.
Wounded duck.
Yeah.
The girl I was with today had a fucking knee brace on.
They just let her out of the fucking quarantine zone, dude. Just let her out.
But I had to listen to this.
She had a knee brace.
She had a fucking knee brace. I was like, what happened to your knee? She's like, I don't know. I went to the doctor. They said it was just not good anymore. I was like, oh, man.
Her boyfriend probably kicked her in the leg.
So...
It's just not good anymore.
Yeah, I was like, she was like, there's no injury to it. It just stopped working. I was like, damn.
I'm just slowly dying.
But, well, no, I feel bad because if she listens to this, I called her out. She's not ugly at all. She's a very nice,
she's
sweet
hot
girl.
As fuck.
She was hot. Yeah.
Anyone
who
works there is hot as fuck.
Yeah, you have
there's
to be hot to work
some
there.
In there that are just like.
There's some that are out of this world.
There's some that you have to avert your eyes. They're so hot. You're like,
oh my God.
Fuck.
Remember that girl walked up to us?
Yeah, dude.
Matt came in to watch me get a haircut the one time, and
we're eating next door. I wasn't just spectating his haircut.
And this girl walked up to us with like a shirt that had like the middle of her tits revealed.
It's like shit Rihanna would wear.
Yeah,
normal people should never
wear
this.
She walked
clothes.
Up to us and was like, "Shane, like to tell me my seat was ready or whatever." And we both were like, "Oh, okay."
I put a magazine in front of my face. Dude, I was like, "Oh God!"
So fucking weird to see.
She's too hot.
Yeah,
you can't have that.
It's like, what are you doing here?
That's like,
get out of here.
That's just like, just fucked up. Girls get that. Some girls that are that hot, it's like, it's just trouble. Unless you literally have $1 billion, I wouldn't feel comfortable dating her unless I had $1 billion. I wouldn't. I'd be like, no way. There's no way that chick's.
I'll
not
tell you who is confident. Yeah. Every single other guy that walks
who
in there
drinks one Amstel
bunch of
Light.
Fucking Dairy Queens from the main board, dude. That's exactly who he is.
I know.
He's the type of guy who would go get his hair cut and be like. They're like, hey, do you want anything to drink? And be like, yeah, can I get a PBR, please? It's like, dude, it's fucking noon on a Tuesday.
Yeah.
No one wants a fucking PBR.
If you're in the haircutter, you're clearly just being a beer, cunt. You'd be like, dude, just cut my fucking hair,
yeah.
All right?
Get a water or nothing.
It's
if
so
you go
weird.
To a fucking hair place, unless you're already drunk, which no one ever is, really.
Yeah.
Don't get a fucking drink. It's weird.
It's such that I've heard people say that too. They've talked about haircutting, like, you know, barbershops or whatever, and like, yeah, but dude, you can like sit down, they have a keg, and they'll pour you a beer, and I'm like, that sounds horrible.
Also, you can't fucking drink it because they're cutting your hair.
Yes, and then
you can't move your head,
and you'll get it, and you fucking if you like, they were doing solo cups. It's like you get your hair all in your beer,
hairs in there, but also you have to stop this fucking girl to be like, hold on, can I get a sip of my fucking now warm.
Yeah,
fucking
all
PBR.
All of her slut germs are flying
all
into your
fucking
beer.
Fucking slut cooties are floating around. Her stinky knee brace is floating around. But the guys that come in there, like, dude, I just sit there, and if I'm not making a motion on my face at all, like if I'm just pure flat face, I have one of the dumbest, ugliest fucking faces on earth, dude. I just sat there and like looked at myself in the mirror like,
I do hate doing that, man.
Fuck, dude. I got so ugly and old so quick.
I've always hated that since I was little. When you have to sit there, or then we're like, how do you look? And they put the mirror in your face, and you're like, just please remove that.
Yeah, it's like, I don't want to see myself, dude. I'm not fucking gay.
Yeah, dude, literally.
I'm a man.
Yeah, fucking send me on my way.
She's like, what do you want to do with the sides? Or like the side, dude, if you ask me what to do with the sideburns, I'm like... Don't fucking act. Just do whatever.
I've never felt comfortable when they're like, well,
just cut my fucking
how's
hair.
This? Even if I hate it, I go, good.
Oh, for sure.
Good.
I've walked out of there like, fuck, dude. That lady fucked my shit up. Yeah, because I don't give a... I'll go to fucking like Good Clips or whatever at like Walmart.
It's like,
I'll be at Walmart buying bucks. Shit and just be like, oh, fuck, I got to cut my hair. Go in there, some fucking morons in there. It's like, you want a mohawk? It's like, fuck, it was a moron, dude. God damn it.
I actually coined a term the other day when I was at Helium and they're watching Catfish, and they're trying to like they were saying that thing where like
they were watching
that girl,
Catfish when I was there.
Yeah, that same thing. Did you see that woman?
No.
They were like some. I think Sydney was saying that she was hot. Two other people were saying no, and they wanted my opinion. And as soon as she came out, I was just like, dude, she has Walmart head. It's when chicks have that big fucking head with huge cheeks. It's just like,
yeah.
It's Walmart head, dude. That's just for fucking scanning. That's for scanning the discounts, dude. Size like a panda. Just big fat jowls and just like.
Yeah, they're built perfectly for fucking scanning the aisles. Finding coupons.
It's a big Walmart head, dude. You can see like your bad kids out of your peripheral and fucking.
Oh my God, dude.
You're just smacking and chopping.
And she got catfished?
I think.
She got catfished by a fucking Sam's Club, dude.
I think the Walmart, I don't know who was catfish. I think the Walmart head was the catfish.
She was catfish, like.
She was catfishing.
So she was faking to be hot.
Yeah, she's pretending she didn't have a big fucking head.
She had to hide her fucking Walmart head.
Yeah, she had a fucking big inflated head. She like she sucked on an air compressor.
Oh my God. But back to the fucking douches getting their hair cut.
Yes.
The level of confidence these guys fucking have, I can't imagine it. They're morons.
Yeah, they are.
It's a moron lady talking to a fucking moron. Well, they might not be morons. It's tough to tell because
they're not quite morons, but
well, no, but they might not be because they might just be like, yeah, whatever. Like whatever the guy says, she's trying to get a fucking tip, so she's gonna like, oh my God,
yeah.
Cool.
But they're like,
the whole point, it's
she's
like
feeling it.
That place is like Hooters for getting your hair cut.
Yeah,
it's like you could go somewhere else with food.
That's to leave with like a semi and a haircut. It's like you leave nice. Like with a one beer Amstel Buzz.
Dude, I walk
and a
out
semi.
Of there the same way I walk out of a strip club. Like the level of awkwardness of like, fuck, dude, I'm fucking weird, dude. I'm not interested in you at all. I want to make that clear to this lady. Like, I swear to God, I'm here for a haircut. She's like, where do you live? I'm like, West Philly. It's like an hour away. Like, this is the only haircut I know.
God damn, man.
These guys, like their level of fucking. What they're saying to these women.
I've heard it.
It's fucking insane. And
it's crazy.
That's, I don't know. There's a lot of those douches out there that are just.
Well, they talk like, they'll come out and be like, the one guy, remember he was talking about being like, right now, I don't know if you know, but flights to Iceland are absolutely
cheap. Oh,
yeah,
that was great.
It's beautiful. You gotta go. Have you been? And it's like, dude.
Yeah, it's like you're talking to a girl who was born in fucking Manayunk.
Yeah.
She has not been to Iceland.
No, and
she's been to Wildwood.
It's basically what it is guys going to get their haircuts and pretending they're on The Bachelor. That's how they talk. They're like, family is very important to me. I know. It's like, dude, shut the fuck up.
Get your fucking crew cut and get the fuck out of here. Yeah, family. Number one, family.
I love to travel.
Also, God. I love God.
Yeah.
I'm big into God now.
I just have the guy said travel bug.
He did say, I got the travel bug.
You got bit by the travel bug. It's like,
Iceland.
Dude.
He's like, no, this is what happened. He was like, flights to Iceland are about $300 right now. And the girl's a fucking airhead. She's like, oh my God. And he's like, no, that's cheap. She's like, oh. It's like, dude, she hasn't left the fucking neighborhood.
Yeah.
Other than to go to a fucking Phillies game.
Yeah, that's literally, that's the big outing.
She went to South Philly once.
She's just like, oh my God. And like the conversation stops and she just grabs his hand and puts it on her tip for a second.
Yeah,
and takes
he's
it
like,
off.
Oh, never mind. I love you.
Oh, great. Watching those guys try to impress those women cutting
their
hair.
They come in, they talk about sometimes work. They all apparently all of them are CEOs.
Oh, yeah.
They're all fucking Gary Vaynerchuk's.
They're
dude.
Bubbling, dude. They're
Every
ready.
Single one of them comes in is like, pretty much I quit what I did, now I do what I love. And like, dude, I just had to fucking support my dreams. Even though that's exactly what we're doing. Fuck yeah.
Yeah, but it's like.
Yeah, but if I have a kid right now, I'm out.
Exactly.
Actually, I'm in too deep now, dude.
That's the worst. That's something that's definitely, I think, plaguing people.
Our generation?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Unrealistic dreams.
Yes.
It's like, dude.
Here's a hot take. Here's a hot racist take, dude. I'm about to drop a racist take.
Well, let's have it.
It is butt-fucking the black community.
Wow.
Butt-fucking the black community.
Now you just gotta say it.
The level of fucking, like, everybody needs to be an artist or a fucking dancer or a producer or a fucking. Dude, it is fucking insane.
Yeah,
you know what I'm talking about, motherfucker.
Those dudes will have full-time jobs and do that on the side. From
regardless,
what I've seen.
Regardless. It's
that,
like, dude,
that's
every,
a
black show,
community.
Every black show I go to,
yeah.
There's three fucking producers.
Yeah.
There's a fucking DJ. There's eight photographers.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, can somebody be in the audience? Can somebody here fucking work?
True. That's still, that also though affects white hipsters the same exact way. Every fucking person I talk to like that, it's like, well, I'm actually a blah, 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 and yeah, I do music. Yeah. It's like...
Yeah, New York especially.
That's New York. Oh, my
God. That's what New York is. I cruise
those dating apps, and it would just be like a girl with fucking black hair, dyed hair, and be like, I'm a comedian. Yeah. I was just like...
It's like, well, first off, what? There's 5 funny female comics.
Yeah.
In Philadelphia.
Dude, that was the funniest.
Well. Yo, yeah. Shout out Lamar Lee. What up, boy? Yo, dude. Shout out Andy Malfreno. What up,
what
boy?
What did Andy Malfreno do?
Andy... So this was the big drama.
What happened? I haven't been on Facebook at all.
This is the story I was given.
Yeah.
And Andy's a good friend of mine, so.
Yeah, they're both good boys.
Yeah, they both are good friends. Both Central PA dogs, dude. Yeah. Came up with them.
Yeah.
So they were at an open mic, Andy and Lemaire, and Andy told a joke along the lines of like, I don't want him to sound shitty because this is going to make his joke sound awful.
Okay.
But he was like, I don't like women, but I love pussy. Along that line.
Okay.
Like,
yeah.
It was of that vein. It's of like,
hacky, yeah.
I don't know if it was hacky, but that's what I was told. I mean, was the premise, basically. Yeah. Of like, I hate women, but I need pussy. Something like that.
I mean,
an age old fucking.
Exactly. I'm not hating on the guy for it.
Can't live with him, can't live without him.
Yeah. I'm not hating on him for it.
No. But apparently, while he was up there, they started, like, playing music to play him off after he said that. And, like, a couple female comics might have started heckling him after he said it.
And how fucking unfunny do you have to be and it's to only, take offense to that?
Yeah, exactly. And it's only because Andy isn't part of this scene. He's not from Philly. So they were like, well, here's a new guy I can bully.
Yes.
They don't know him yet, so I can bully him. And it's like, dude, you guys are fucking nobodies.
Yeah.
You don't fucking do that to anybody.
Well, especially for stand-up, too. And it's like, dude, my whole thing is like, if I did that to them every time they had a stupid fucking take that I was like, that's absolutely retarded.
Yeah, or if you were offended.
Yeah, oh my God.
I get offended by the shit they say.
Yeah, if they're like, I just get annoyed by it.
It was another white guy that fucking ruined it. Actually, no, that's not what I would get offended by. I'd get offended by them.
But it's annoying when they say that shit. Just their
constant fucking shit, yeah.
That even that, being like, and this is the white guy.
And this isn't just females. This is also their fucking...
Well, the fucking pussy male counterparts. Yeah. Those dudes are disgusting, where it's like... I can't stand that, man. That's what Philadelphia comedy is now. If you want to do stand-up in Philadelphia, just hang out with a bunch of people, be okay at it. If,
just,
you know,
befriend a bunch of women and occasionally... Oh, so here's what else happened.
Yeah.
Let's go back to this story.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So after the show, I don't know exactly what happened there, but that's the story I was given, was Andy was kind of fucking shooed off the stage after he made a sexist joke.
Come on, man.
So then... Lemaire, his friend, gets on Facebook and is like, fuck that mic and fuck female comics. There's only 5 funny female comics in Philly anyway. The rest of you suck.
True. That's 100% true.
He's got a decent point.
Dude, that's so
now,
true.
Now, it depends what you mean by funny. That's where it gets fucking dicey.
Serviceable.
You mean like serviceable like 20 minutes at a club?
10 minutes, dude.
10 minutes at a club?
Yeah.
All right, yeah. Then you're looking at... And we're not counting some of the, I don't know. Yeah, fuck, that's close.
Yeah.
It's close to that number. Regardless, regardless, he shouldn't be saying that. Even if you agree.
20, say 20 minutes at a club.
Yeah, there's 3.
Yes, that's the truth.
But he shouldn't have said that. He just made a shitty Facebook post because he was mad that his friend got fucking run off the stage by these people. And it ended up being like a 400 fucking comment post.
Of course, dude.
Of fucking... Nobody's coming out of the fucking woodwork like, I'm funny, blah, blah, blah. Dude, and it's like, dude, you do stand-up once every 3 months, or you just started doing stand-up within the year. If you're a female comic, or any comic, and you just started stand-up this year, you fucking suck.
Yeah.
You're not a comic yet. You fucking suck.
That's true.
I've been doing this 7 years, and I'm not a comic really yet. I'm getting there.
And you can do 45.
I can do 45, yeah. And I'm just getting there.
Dude, they're doing 5 minutes for people who, like, if you say certain words, they'll laugh.
It's nightmarish. But, so there's this huge thing, and then it gets to the point, Andy, or fucking Lemaire apologized.
What a bitch.
He fucking backed down, and he had to apologize. He had to kiss the fucking ring. Because everyone was like...
He had to kiss the gnarled hand.
So then, all these fucking female comics come back out, and are like, we knew you were a sweetheart. It's like, dude, Lemaire's a fucking idiot. He's not a sweetheart, dude. He's a mean dickhead.
Yeah, he is.
He's funny. I love him.
Yeah.
But, dude, if Lemaire's white, I don't know if they're fucking hitting the old, but we love you.
No, dude.
I don't think they're hitting that.
They wouldn't. I've heard him say shit like that on stage. They didn't boo him off.
No.
But they're all, dude, if that whole crowd of, like, you know, hip women comedian who are socially pushing, whatever, if they know that you can't, and the dudes, they're fucking lame counterparts, but if they know that they can kind of get something off you, if you're in a position above them where, like, they can kind of, maybe if they're in your favor, they just leave you alone.
Yeah, for sure.
They don't do anything to you.
Yeah, if you book a good show, they're fucking not saying a word to you.
And they're like, oh, thanks for putting me on, blah, blah, blah. It's like... Yep.
But if you're a fucking new guy to the scene and you come on and you try a fucking...
Yeah.
Look, there's going to be shitty jokes. There's going to be fucking misogynistic, racist, homophobic, shitty jokes.
Yeah. And then
that's what we're doing at a fucking open mic.
Exactly.
And if it's bad, just don't fucking laugh.
Yeah.
Let them fucking stew in a bomb. That's way worse than being like, fuck yeah.
Trying to control the ethics of a comedy open mic is like the most... It's just
trying
like
to... Yeah, dude. Controlling the ethics of a comedy open mic is fucking disgusting.
It's not funny. It's like you're literally doing that, you're not funny.
Yep.
The part that makes your brain funny hears that and goes, ugh. And if you're like, and then you're not funny. That's it of that.
Lemaire, you should have never fucking apologized, dude.
Yeah.
Should have stood by that. Although you shouldn't have fucking said there's 5 foot. You just shouldn't have come out and said that. You should just keep that shit to yourself.
I don't even, I read all that shit anymore and I don't even like.
It's like, why would you fucking say that?
I don't even, I like look at it and I'm like, okay.
Hopefully that's what his apology was. Hopefully his apology was just like, yeah, I shouldn't have said that.
Pretty much. But
hopefully that's what he meant. Yeah. I hope he wasn't like, all the women in the community are great. Oh, dude. After he posted that, it spurred like 5 different comics to post names of female comics and like a playbill review of them. Like, you know what I mean? Like a fucking,
I know,
like,
exactly what you're talking about.
So-and-so is a powerful force on stage. Every time I see her, she makes me cringe, but also super happy. She's super powerful. All this, and it's like, dude, do you realize how fucking crazy that is?
Yeah. Or how contrived that is.
And also,
is
what about the fucking chick you left off the list now? You fucking retard.
I know.
It's ridiculous.
It's so contrived. And you can't tell me the person doing that isn't in their head being like, yes, 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 while they're like, everyone's going to know how good I am. It's like, dude.
Jesus Christ. I saw a couple people write statuses that were like, I don't want to cause drama, but here's a list of 5 female comics or 10 that are phenomenal. And it's like, dude. You think they're phenomenal?
Yeah.
I know the people on this list. I would not watch half of them for more than fucking 10 minutes. It would be like, fuck, this sucks.
I wouldn't use the word phenomenal either.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
But again, dude, imagine again, if you're, I mean, okay, assuming they're not lying just to butter someone's bread for some reason. Maybe your mental capacity, you see someone, you're like, that was phenomenal. It's like. Not everyone's fucking, you know,
yeah,
maybe
true.
my brain's fucked up. Maybe yours is.
That was like when he was like, there's 5 funny female comics.
Yeah.
And then they started being like, there's fucking 20. I was like, well, so does that mean like there's a goofy lady? That's
exactly.
Like quirky?
Yeah. Funny
it's
is like,
yeah, that's funny. Sure.
Funny is killing. If you're like crushing audiences, I'm like, oh, they're funny.
There's not 5 funny female or funny comics in Philadelphia.
Yeah. I guess that then now you have to use funny.
That's what you mean.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
What I like when I read that. Yeah.
They're not like that. I'd be like, damn, I can't wait to see that person.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'm like, yeah, I've seen them before. They're not, you know, they're doing their thing. When you watch them on the, anyone who does the open mics, who does them consistently, when you see the contest, that's when you're like, all right, this person's better than your average fucking straggler that walks in, practices 8 miles in the mirror, and you're like, all right, but dude, it's like, you're not that good. That's the thing. Like, you're doing it for 2 years. You're not important. You're not that good. Suck it up.
Yeah.
I don't know why they have to, but I'm telling you, I think it's a lot of emotionally weak people.
Oh,
need
fuck,
that constant
dude.
Bolstering.
And this
like,
is like for the people that are listening to this that are like, all right, shut the fuck up about comedy and open mics and all that shit. But that's what it is. The open mic scene and any comedy scene in a city is just an army of it's an army of morons, dude.
Dude, it is.
It's an army of damaged fucking people, dumb fucking people, and lonely people that are like, this is a good social outlet. Like,
well,
once you realize that people are like, I'm never going to be a good comedian, I'm just here doing this open mic.
Friends, yeah.
Because that's what they are.
Yeah.
A lot of these people are just treading water.
For friends.
Just to be like, this is our fun scene.
That's the dude.
And it's like, why the fuck are you doing that, dude?
Oh, man, that's so weird to me.
Join a fucking bowling league. Get out of here. I don't
need
to
fucking hear
you talk.
Why would you take that mental stress upon yourself? And then it's like, ugh, and you invite all your friends out, and you're like, come watch me at my show. And it's like, I don't know.
All right, we should fucking...
We should
take
stop.
A break or end it or what? Where are we at?
I don't know where we're at. The whole thing, too, is like my new fascination is with morons who have passed through college and now kind of understand certain abstract concepts. When you take it away, it's just like, it's just hollow. They're absolutely still fucking morons.
What, morons that understand like what?
Just like social injustice, to be like, yeah, there's, but they can't think about like, well, where did it come from? Who does it actually affect? It's, dude, that's like plaguing people right now.
It was funny. I was the whole way here. This is something. So yesterday I drove in a car for like fucking 12 hours.
Yeah.
And I got to listen to all of Dan Carlin's Ghost of the Ostfront. It's one of the things online you can buy off his website. It's like fucking thing. It's about the Eastern Front in World War II. So it's the Nazis versus the Germans, or the Nazis versus the Soviets, and it's just pure fucking like.
Oh, he's talked about like that
fucking
shit before.
Chaos, dude. It's like, so of 7 out of every 8 Nazis, I think, that died in World War II died on the Eastern Front.
Everybody
died over there. Like, we lost like 400,000, I think, casualties maybe, or deaths, regardless. The other side, that was like a battle for them.
Yeah, I heard we
that
sat
was like
back.
One battle.
So we didn't we sit back and let them fucking. Dogger it out for a while?
We sat back and let the world battle it for a minute. Well, the Soviets kind of sat back, too, because they thought they were allies with the Nazis. And then the Nazis hit them with a little sneak attack.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
It's a very Nazi thing to do.
Yeah, it's a very Nazi thing to do.
Yes, we are your friends.
Yeah, we are very good friends, yeah? No. And then Stalin was getting, like, reports that the Nazis were coming, and he was like, fuck you, you're lying, you're trying to ruin our cool friendship. And he would, like, kill people for it. But, yeah, I don't want to get into this again.
That's funny.
But I was listening to this and the atrocities, just the horrible war crimes and like all this shit. And then I come inside and like I'm watching a social justice thing on TV and I'm just like, boy, things have changed.
Yeah.
Like this is a problem now.
Yeah.
It's like, we need to use the same bathroom. I'm a woman. And it's like, dude, I just listened to 5 hours of fucking Soviet and Nazi atrocities, dude.
Yeah.
Last thing I need is to hear you bitch about your fucking donger.
People getting buried in fucking ice alive. You just get thrown into a pool of ice and they put an army tank over you until you die.
There was
It's crazy. And that's a funny thing, too, when it's like people who go to like Harvard and they're like, I'm an oppressor. And it's like, no, you're fucking, you're not oppressed at all.
Yeah, you want to talk about oppression.
You're at Harvard.
Talk about a fucking Polak during World War II.
Yeah, exactly.
Then you got fucking... pounded, dude.
Dude, that shit.
You can't believe. It was funny he said it because towards the end of it, he was like, "The only thing this is comparable to is the rape of Nanking." Oh yeah, that's another thing
I wanted to fucking add on.
The rape of Nanking. So I talked about it a little bit last week without really doing enough research on it.
Yeah,
I knew it was horrible. That's all I knew,
dude.
I knew a little bit about how horrible it was, and then Steve Gerben sent me that fucking Jocko podcast about it. Woo! If you're bored right now. And obviously you are if you're listening to this. Two podcasts you need to listen to. The Hardcore History about the Ghosts of the Ostfront, which is like, it's like $5 for all of them. And then Jocko Willink. Is that his name?
Willink or something?
Willink. Anyway, like if you type in Jocko, J-O-C-K-O. Just type in that. And then I think it's like episode 60, I think.
Yeah.
If I remember correctly.
I believe so.
But it's about the Rape of Nanking. Dude. And, dude, you won't be able to get through it.
Just I got through it.
Listening to the atrocities, though, I mean, you're going to have to take, like, a break or, like...
I was in traffic, so I was kind of pissed anyway, and I was like, motherfucker, and I was listening to it, and I was every now and again I'd stop and be like, Jesus fucking Christ.
Dude, I was just walking in the rain. I walked down to fucking, like, Saxby's to get my daily iced coffee.
So we're approaching our... I have the song loaded up.
What?
We're approaching it. I hope it doesn't fuck up our audio.
What do you mean?
Hold on, let's stop real quick. I see something.
All right.
My bad's about that.
No, it's good. So we were talking about the Rape of Nanking.
Yeah.
And listen to that Jocko podcast. It's like...
I mean, dude, you're talking
about... It's fucking unbelievable, man.
Literally cutting women's stomachs open and ripping out fetuses.
Yeah.
That's one of them.
Yeah, that's nothing. I don't want to talk about it because it's fucked up. They're like holding, making Chinese soldiers like fuck their mothers and stuff.
Yeah. And that's the thing, dude. And it's like... I mean, I get it too, being like, well, that doesn't even apply. It's like... Yeah, but maybe think about that and be like, well, at least we don't deal with that. Being like, our society is so fucked up.
It's not.
Yeah, there's definitely some bad shit lingering around, but like, dude, Jesus Christ, it can get so bad.
Well, anyway, the point of this was, sure. It's like, I don't want to hear you argue, like, it's like the police are fucking Nazis. It's like, well, why don't you fucking slow down on Nazis? Because it's a little different.
Yeah, I told you about that, how they were that group was trying to abolish all police in Chicago. It was like these activists.
I think we talked about that.
Trans women. Did we finish that? Did we or did we delete that?
I don't know.
Maybe. But it's the same difference. They're like, abolish the police in Chicago. It's like, good luck.
Yeah, see ya. Well, bye.
Bye.
So one thing, this is what I wanted to reiterate from last week, was that the whole point of the fucking conversation last week was like the Japanese deserved the atomic bomb.
Yeah.
They fucking earned that fucking...
And people will fight you for that.
And people will be like, that's horrific to say. And it's like, dude, I thought they deserved it before Rape of Nanking, that I'd listened to anything they did. Oh, for sure. They were fucking cunts, dude. Yeah. I knew about the fucking Bataan Death March and how they treated everyone.
About all this shit,
I know about the way they treated people.
If I were to stop 25 people on the street and be like, what happened in Japan before World War I? I don't fucking know.
The World War II. The real point is...
See?
Yeah. The real point is that it saved lives, technically. Dropping the atomic bomb was like, all right, now we're done. Otherwise, we're going to keep doing this to you. So that we didn't have to invade the mainland.
So they were trying to like rule Asia.
Because then if we would have had to have land invaded Japan, we would have been fucked. Well, like if we would have invaded the main island of Japan, it would have cost millions of lives.
Which one of the armies in Asia had Goro?
That was definitely not the Chinese. That was the fucking Japs, dude. They had Goro.
I'm just going.
That's who was at the Rape Nanking.
I'm going through, like, did you ever play story mode in Mortal Kombat? That was just the Japanese conquest.
Yeah,
like,
they
just
climbed
an all
up the
Asian
mountain.
An all Asian war. They're just fucking throwing lightning bolts at each other.
Yeah, except they're doing some other things.
Yeah,
they're
throwing
lightning bolts into raping an entire city.
Jesus Christ.
But the Japanese at the Rape of Nanking killed or tortured basically the entire city, which was like, the casualties are somewhere around like 300,000, which is almost, so in one city, China lost almost as much as the United States total in World War II and England total in World War II.
How many people got killed by the bomb again?
The bomb was only like 40,000, I think.
In Hiroshima and the other city?
Yeah, I think Nagasaki was smaller.
And
I think
they
Nagasaki
killed 300,000
like,
people in China?
I mean, they tortured 300,000 people.
Tortured, raped,
they
killed.
They raped, tortured, cut dicks off.
Boiled babies.
Boiled babies. They fucking made people fuck their own mothers.
Well, that's the thing, dude. You
suck their people's dicks. They fucking did the war. They made monks that promised celibacy.
They were cutting birds off, dude,
they were
left
cutting
and right.
Birds constantly.
If you didn't fuck your mom, they cut your bird off.
Yeah.
Think to fucking wrap your head around that. And then that's the thing, when someone... Like, you watch a documentary, though, and it's like, we dropped the bomb on them. And like, they were just over there fucking, like...
It's just a peaceful group.
Moving paper dragon costumes all over the place. It's like,
they were out,
man.
They were the worst fucking people ever.
Well, that's... If you read enough history, everyone is fucked up.
Everyone's awful.
Everyone's fucked up
and
bad. That's
all I've been ever trying to say.
Yeah, and that's true.
Even that fucking dude. I listened to that Sebastian Younger fucking thing on Joe Rogan again about tribe and how, like, no Native Americans ever escaped to the colonies and all the colonists... Like,
what do you mean?
Occasionally a colonist in North America would escape and join the Native Americans.
Yeah.
And be like, women are more empowered here. We all live off the land and it's like super
positive.
Oh, they'd
come back and be like.
Yeah. But it's like, dude, I fucking hate when people group all Native Americans together.
With one tribe.
Dude.
Plus, if there's a.
They were fucking animals.
Well, plus, if there was so if that's based off of a guy who just ran away and joined a tribe.
Yeah.
That was probably, that tended to be a more open and peaceful tribe. It'd be like, yeah, come
for
on
sure.
in, we'll take you in.
For sure.
He could have went to, like, he had a little path in the woods. If he had made a left, they might have been like, honk and cut his fucking hair off.
Yeah, they might have cut his tongue out.
They
might have
Aunt Sergio'd his fucking hair.
Yeah, a bunch of hot Aunt Sergio's come out. Tell me about the weather and your travels.
Well, to take
cut
one,
your dick off.
That is weird. That's a weird thing, too, I think. People
Everybody's
in our generation
evil. That's
suffer.
All you need to know about
that's
history.
That's the thing that people in our generation suffer from is utopian visions of being like, our society could be perfect. It's like, no, it fucking can't.
Well,
it never will
it
be.
It can never be perfect, but you're right. You definitely hit the fucking nail on the head about, for some reason, certain atrocities in certain races and countries are remembered more than other ones. And it's like... Like, if you look at the history of Africa right now, if you ask the normal person, it's like, it's kind of the same way we paint the Native Americans. It's this white guilt history of, like, they were beautiful and peaceful, and then white people showed up and ruined it.
Yeah.
It's like, no, dude, they were butt fuckers, and they got butt fucked by a bigger butt fucker.
Yeah.
That's all it is,
well, it's
dude.
Gangs in New York.
This is Gangs in New York.
Gangs in New York, all the gangs are fighting, and then the U.S. Army comes in, just fucks them all up, and it's like, ah, you know what?
Yeah, it was Gangs in New York. That's exactly what was going on. Yeah. There was a bunch of fucking plug uglies and fucking 40 thieves and all these fucking retards fighting on the shore, and our boats showed up, and we're like, all right, well, we can just take this.
Yeah.
There's only morons here.
Yeah.
This is our land, because these are morons.
It's annoying to the one-sided thing of that. Of how they're like, you know, everyone was just playing flutes and dancing. It's like, well, you know.
How do you think they got that flute?
Well, no,
it's like
also
they stole it from a guy who was playing it before him and cut his fucking dick off. And they raped his wife.
That's been the way, dude. It used to be like slave, master. Like that was just, how you would be like, you would grow shit, then people would come and take it, and you'd cut their heads off, or just like a mass fucking people. It was
and even if you had a nice life in a nice village or whatever.
Yeah.
Eventually, there was going to be someone horrific fucking experience where you lose everybody you love, or you watch them die, or
that they need to start. That is a bad thing about people not knowing stuff, because then all they do is they watch a now this clip, and it's like,
Africans invented everything, and they were super peaceful, and like there's so many powerful kingdoms, and then white people ruined it because they were jealous. It's like, that's not history.
Yeah, it's not.
I watched a fucking animated Malcolm X speech today.
Uh-huh.
It was fucking insane.
What was it?
He was talking about the house N-word.
Yeah.
And like I don't know. It was just fucking very crazy shit.
Well, that I mean.
And now there's a revisionist history, particularly on him too, on Malcolm X. He was a fucking he was a bit of a fucking drug dealer. Well,
I read his biography.
I'm sure that's a nice biography though.
No, it's not. It's literally. He used to sell numbers. He was a drug dealer. They used to call him Red. That was like his nickname.
I think he had some domestic violence in there. Could be wrong on that.
I forget. I don't know. But I know he was like a thug, basically.
Yeah, but it's
and
like.
Then he started. Then he did. I think he finally got off his super, exclusionary thing where he was like, fuck white people.
Yeah,
and then
and
he died.
And then other black people killed him.
But dude, it's also though, it's everyone has a piece of the truth, because it's like, if you were to come, it also was so fucking hard to be black. Like, when
came
from slave era. So that makes sense. But then it's people go fucking full tilt on it. And
It's like, this wasn't some fucking peaceful, nice guy that was like a beautiful. I don't know. He was only a drug dealer because it was the white man's fault.
Yeah.
That's the version of history we have now.
Yeah.
There's no. And that's definitely true. That's partially true.
Yeah.
There's no fucking culpability. If you're an extremist, so if you're a white supremacist, or if you're one of the people that are like, minorities are the best, and
Black,
super
it's Black Hitler, dude, you got to watch this guy.
I will check out Black Hitler. There's no middle ground. There's no accountability. Like, so if the question is why are African Americans struggling or being segregated in America?
Yeah.
A white racist would be like, because they suck.
Yeah.
And they're only worried about hip hop and gang banging, and they glorify drugs, and they're not excited about education and all this shit. And then other people be like, it's white people's fault. It's systematic oppression. It's fucking all that shit. It's white people's fault.
Yeah.
They were slaves. They never had a chance. They're put in government housing, all this fucking shit.
Mm-hmm.
But it's somewhere in between that.
Yeah. Both sides.
Somewhere in the middle.
Both sides. Maybe have a little snippets of truth. That's all it is. Well, it's like anytime a young kid gets shot, it's like, well, the police are fucked up. And it's like, yeah, dude, the police shouldn't shoot kids. But it's also, if you go into those neighborhoods, the fucking murder rates through the roof.
Yeah.
So the cops are fucking scared.
Cops are terrified.
And why is the murder rate high?
Maybe not terrified, but they're prepared.
Some of those cops
are
scared as fuck.
They're prepared.
I used to talk to those cops. Guys were undercover drug cops, and they were like, dude, if I think someone has a gun, I'm killing them. I'm not dying. I have kids.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't care. I'd rather kill someone and walk away.
Yeah.
And they're like, dude, if you did my job, you'd do the same fucking thing. And it's fucked up.
It is. It's terrible.
But it's like, it's horrible. But at the same time, it's like when they do the same shit, it's like they're just walking around. They're predators. It's like, dude, cops don't even like doing paperwork. They're not just shooting people willy-nilly, dude. I don't know.
I saw an interesting one of those. Hold on. I'll find it.
That's
here.
So fucking weird to me. Plus, it is like, and then there, it's like no one, and that's the hot button issue. And it's like, because then you, like you said, people are like, well, what about the black on black crime? And they'll be like, well, that's none of your business. And it's like, but if you're a cop and you just saw like a fucking 12-year-old girl get shot in the head by a stray bullet, and now you're walking in the same neighborhood, you're fucking like,
yeah.
Yeah. It's so fucking dismal. And some of them get like real disillusioned, where they're like, well, fuck this whole place, and it's you know, there's just no easy solution. If you literally make a little tiny 4 second clip and think you nailed the hit, if you like figured out the fucking crime and the hood and cops and police brutality, it's like you're a fucking idiot.
This is an interesting fucking little, this is a perfect example of that. What so Colin Kaepernick had a shirt on and his shirt makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
This is good. It's a good two-sided fucking, this is on some fucking,
what is it?
Alt-right meme website. But there's a picture of Colin Kaepernick and he's wearing a shirt that says, "We march, y'all mad. We sit down, y'all mad. We speak up, y'all mad. We die, y'all silent." And yeah, he's got some good points.
Mm-hmm.
And then this fucking Blue Lives Matter guy comes out and he's like, "We patrol your neighborhood, y'all mad." Or no, "Y'all complain. We leave your neighborhood, y'all complain. We speak, y'all sue. We die, y'all celebrate." It's like, yeah, both true.
Yeah, really, exactly.
Both sides have a pretty good point.
Yeah. What do you do?
There's, we need to do something other than polarize both sides completely.
Yeah.
And that's...
well, it's people looking at themselves.
They won't look at themselves.
Neither side.
Neither side will look at themselves.
That's, dude, that's 100, that's 150%
and
true.
And be like, what the fuck am I doing here?
Exactly. For a cop to be like, am I a little weirdly aggressive into it? Maybe I go into a black neighborhood. Maybe I take stuff out on these little teenagers I see. And I'm like, get the fuck out of here. Like, their wife didn't give him pussy. Definitely happens. Maybe. Then it's like, are you being shitty?
Maybe. You guys prioritizing education and hard work?
Well, dude.
Or are you guys going to be hip?
even rap. That's
that was a little hard. Yes, rap is very
bad.
Fucked up. Rap
so if you
is
have,
bad.
If you have a thing that's, you know, factually, there's more homes with, like, there's less fathers per capita.
Yeah.
And then there's, where's the father figure? You listen to fucking Chief Keef. And that's where you're downloading all your info from?
Yeah.
That's bad. I can't listen to rap anymore.
The argument is the dad's not around because the white man's imprisoning him.
Well, that and the whole thing with, like, I don't understand it, but there was like a Section 8 thing where, like, it was cost effective not to get married, because if you were a single mom, your Section 8 housing would get, like, approved.
Oh,
I don't understand.
Well, that makes sense. But, yeah, as a single...
They were saying, like, they systematically broke up the family.
A single mother gets the highest... She gets rewarded the most welfare.
Yeah.
And all that. So, yeah, that makes sense.
But it was, like, if you didn't have... There's something about, like, the living situation. You can get government housing, but if you had a husband, it fucks up your ability to get that.
But
you know why
is...
we also have... You get money per kid?
Yeah.
You know how, like, you get tax credits?
Yeah.
That was Teddy Roosevelt. He wanted white people to have more kids, so he didn't get, like, our race to get, like, washed out. So he started giving money out to have kids.
Talk about your all-time backfires, Teddy. Old Teddy didn't see that one coming.
Oh, fucking hobbling Teddy. The old Rough Rider.
The old Bull Moose, dude.
Dude, that shit is so funny. Where all of our stuff comes from, it's, like, just all crazy ideas.
It's wild shit.
Thrown and they stick, and it's like, yeah, you get $3,500 or whatever it is per kid.
Dude, I mean, think about them looking back and be like, yeah, there was a guy who ran that fucking said he was going to build a wall to keep out the Mexicans.
Yeah, now we just have this, like, wall.
Now we have a giant wall that fucking Banksy made cool art on. Yeah.
I'm telling you, man, the more you really, like, learn about this shit, dude, it's like whenever all that conspiracy stuff goes out the window.
Yeah, learn
it's like,
history.
Dude, nobody has a grip on it. This is a wild fucking thing that's spinning out of control that people just kind of get and hold on to. And are like
there's
the 1%.
No fucking...
Everyone talks about the 1%. That changes constantly.
Oh, yeah.
There's people in there who, you know, the Rothschilds and shit, but most of it, it's like you're the 1% for a while. You get butted out, and new person in there.
I know a couple rich kids that are definitely not carrying on that 1% legacy. I know a bunch of rich kids that are falling off that cliff.
Yeah, dude. It happens.
Yeah.
Hell but, yeah.
I think we hit the fucking... I think we're getting close on that fucking... on that racial tension between the police and Black Lives Matter,
it's
dude.
True.
I think you and me are the missing link in the middle.
I think we are, dude. We're like this, fucking... We have a finger in the dam,
dude.
We're holding it
we're
up.
Like, we're like that clip of Larry David when he's at the... You know what I'm talking about? You ever see that?
No, what is it?
In Curb Your Enthusiasm? When he's in between two protests and he's kind of debating like...
I thought you were talking about the one where he has the guy... he has a survivor. And so he like thinks the guy's talking about the Holocaust and he brings a person from the show Survivor and then the Holocaust Survivor and they're talking about like what was harder. Dude, that was the funniest fucking thing I've ever...
Well, that's great. But no, the one I'm talking about, there's a very popular gif
of
Larry David between two protests, and he's kind of like very visibly weighing the options.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, the listener who knows about that is
that's
laughing.
That's fucking funny.
That's what, that's you and me between Blue Lives and Black Lives Matter right now. We're both like, well, I see both sides a little bit.
There's, I mean, dude, there's
both some valid points.
That's, it's so fucking weird, man. Because you can definitely be right about one thing or wrong about another. Yeah. It's like,
and you can be, both sides can be right.
That's true too. Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Both sides have good points.
Plus, there's a lot of people who don't want to see it come to a resolution. They just love getting fired up. They love getting fucking bullshit. It's both sides of that too.
There's both sides. Who just love it? People they're feed dug off in. The fucking drama,
dude. They're dug in. There's a bunch of Pennsylvania gone wild. They're dug in.
There was a fucking Black Lives Matter thing that got in trouble because they called in. They were like, "We had to cancel the rally because of a bomb threat," and then the police searched and found that, like, they found the video clip from the computer that it came from, the computer lab that it came from, and the camera, and it was them. They made their own bomb threat. Like, there's a ton of that shit going on.
Yeah, that,
like,
happened a lot.
Well, we've made being a social activist the coolest thing in the fucking world. Yeah. So now, like, and don't get me wrong, why for black people, it's kind of important.
Yeah.
But for, like, it's like, I'm actually bi-curious fucking blah, 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 and yeah, I'm an activist for that. It's like, dude, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Just go jerk off however you want.
Yeah, go
fuck whoever you want, jerk off.
Exactly.
No one's, you don't need to march.
Put on your leather. I mean, it's, I guess, you, like, don't, your need it. Parents are mad.
I bet your parents aren't mad. Most parents are kind of like, man, that's fucking weird you're doing that, but yeah, I still love you. Here's like, 20 bucks.
Yeah. What, yeah, the, I mean, fuck? That's not comparable to, like, when they try to be like, if they try to compare, and a lot of black people hate this, when gay people try to compare themselves to black people, and they're like,
they fucking should.
Dude, you know nothing of.
Yeah.
Like, they used to, people used to own your kids and sell them. Like, that's bad. But they're not, like, stealing gay people and making them fucking, like, yeah, decorate their fucking house.
Yeah.
That is not, I mean, it's not the same thing.
They had, gay people had, like, Matthew Shepard a while back.
Milk?
Black people are fucking crushing that.
Who's Matthew Shepard?
Kid who got,
oh, who got
hate crimed.
Yeah.
That was their fucking Ferguson.
Yeah, that was, like,
but then, the since 90s? Then, Black Lives Matter has had, like, fucking, Orlando Castillo, fucking all these fucking
guys.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah, that was in the 90s. He got, like, dragged on a pickup truck.
And he got beat up by two retards, not the police.
Yeah. Yeah, so there it is.
Yeah, so gay people, shut the fuck up, dude.
Yeah, fucking take a minute. Just chill for a minute, man.
We need to focus on Black Lives Matter.
Yeah,
not damn, fucking, dude, that's sick. We're Black Lives Matter now.
Dude, we're BLM.
We are, big time.
Hell yeah, dude. Fuck yeah.
Yes.
Gay lives, chill.
Gay lives, shut the fuck up,
GLC,
dude. What do you think about fucking...
GLSTFU.
What do you think about Jew Lives Matter, dude?
Dude, that's the other thing now. A lot of the...
Oh, the Jews are jumping on that bandwagon
no,
quick.
No, dude, it's weird. A lot of the... What I've noticed is a lot of the hard, like, Uhuru and heavy Black Lives Matter are like, yeah, I'm anti-Semitic. Here's why.
Oh.
Dude, so like...
Who's Uhuru?
It's like a... I don't even know what it is. It's like this... It's like... It was around before Black Lives Matter... And they have a lot of like thrift shops, and it's like a political grassroots movement.
Uhuru?
Yeah, Uhuru. I don't know, honestly don't know what it is.
Uhuru?
I know they do a lot of like flea marketing and
so
a lot
it's kinda
of,
like FUBU except bodegas.
No, it's not, it's like political community organizers who I know like do money through like they have thrift markets and shit, and I don't know what it is. I couldn't talk about it enough. I don't
fish
know.
Fish fries or whatever.
Yeah, it's like a small political movement. You know, it would have been like the NRA if it was just like no guns and just like super pro black. It's like a political
group.
I
understand.
Dug in.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But yeah, dude.
And they're fucking anti-Semitic.
This one guy who is like speaking on behalf of them is like makes these videos. I got to show you the guy's things, dude.
Is that Black Hitler?
Black Hitler.
Oh, fuck yeah.
He's just like, yeah, I'm anti-Semitic. Here's why. He's like, I hate interracial relationships. It's just
damn.
A fucking...
It's just a black-white supremacist.
Redneck. Yeah, it's a black-white fucking black supremacist.
Well, that's another thing people seem to be forgetting is there are retards on all sides.
Yeah.
Like, we and here's...
That's true, too. Because they'll be like, share this. It's like, that guy's a fucking moron.
A lot of these guys that are listening to this come from communities where this isn't as rammed down your throat, but with stand-up, we hear it every fucking day that the white guys are the worst guys. It's like, dude, there are fucking shitty gay dudes.
Yeah.
There are shitty black dudes. There are shitty Hispanics.
Dude, remember the gay guy who
there
got a bomb in his mail?
Shithole Chinamans.
Do you remember that? It was... What? 6 months ago, a gay guy got a bomb in the mail, and everyone's like, this is a hate crime, bro.
I'm sure it was... What happened?
I know for a fact that, so I know someone who was working for the police and they had to investigate what happened. That guy was using, Grindr, one of those apps, and getting like a ton of young boys. He was just like running young boys through his house and just getting his dick sucked constantly. And he was doing something that was like, the fuck was this guy doing? He was fucking around with him, just like treating him like shit. And one of the guys was a fucking foreign exchange student and built a bomb and mailed it to him.
Oh, fuck. Oh, so it was a gay. It was gay on gay crime.
Yeah, he was just dogging all these young gay kids. Dude, he was just fucking pimping them
out. I'll bet you. See, here's it. This, and is,
like, this is a hate. People were posting on Facebook like another horrible hate crime.
This is a fucking. This is a hot take, but it's very fucking annoying. Is shit like that? The fucking now this or fucking cycle videos of like, check out this new hate crime of Trump supporters. Yeah. And it's some fucking retard spray painted a swastika on a dugout in a park, and it's like, dude, was that even a fucking white guy?
Yeah.
Whoever spray painted the N-word on LeBron James's house, you haven't heard a thing about that since then. I bet they caught a black dude doing
They've caught a bunch of them. And I always watch out for, like, you know, reverse propaganda.
You gotta watch that shit.
But I've heard a bunch of them and read articles and verified that, like, dude, there's been, again, and that's another thing. There's people who I know are black and like, dude, I've definitely been called the N-word like 5 times since Trump got elected. It didn't happen before. But then there's a bunch of, I've heard that from a couple of people, but then there's been a bunch of those things where like swastikas coming up.
You always toss in the H.
I took a swastika. Swastika. I call them schwastikas.
You always throw in the schwa.
But yeah, dude, there was a ton of times where they got caught like just drawing. Imagine being like a 40-year-old black dude and spray painted a swastika.
Dude, that's how Black Lives Matter started basically in Ferguson at Missouri at the university.
Yeah.
And it started with like a fucking poop swastika.
I heard about that.
And I think that ended up being fake.
The poop swat. I think that was fake.
That was an inside job, dude. That was a poop swat. That was an inside job.
That was me and my boys, dude.
We got a lot of inside poop swastika jobs.
They called me up. They're like, yo, I heard you're the man in terms of shitting and stuff. I was like, yeah.
Lots of inside swastikas. Dude, well, anyway.
That's wild, dude, though. That's a wild conspiracy to like, at what point would an organization be like, here's what we're going to do. We're going to shit. Do a shit swastika.
Well, probably somebody did it and then somebody else saw it and was like, oh my God. And they were like, oh fuck. Like, I can't. Like, some dude.
That was some. I think we looked into that and that was a kid did that. No, I think we. I don't know what happened with that.
I think the poop swastika was an inside job, dude. Really? I think that was one of the black kids that.
Because we were talking about some kid waking up and being like, oh fuck, I did the poop swastika.
Oh, yeah. We were making fun of the fact that, like, it was definitely just a drunk college kid. Because it's funny as fuck. A poop swastika?
He's like, I gotta quit drinking.
So what did you do? Like, dude, like, that wasn't even about black dudes, dude. I was just kidding. Why the fuck would the black people get offended?
You imagine that? Like, I'd be like, you want a beer? It's like, nah, man, I quit drinking. Like, oh, what happened? You drinking too much? Like, I did the poop swastika.
I'm the guy who started Black Lives Matter. Fucking took a shit and smeared a swastika on the window. And now there's a huge... Now police officers got shot in Dallas. It's like, yeah, I've got to quit drinking.
The one poop swastika that toppled Western civilization.
One shit swastika destroyed the greatest empire the earth has ever seen. Hats off to that kid, dude.
Wow. Oh my God, that guy's just fucking sipping a PBR right now.
Right now that guy is at a fucking, he's an accountant. He's just sitting there just. He's still scribbling, looking around nervously, like, oh, God, dude. Every day he turns on the news, it's like, another black person shot. He's just, oh, fuck. Blue Lives Matter flags.
It wasn't supposed to be this way.
He breaks a pencil.
It's a funny joke for me and my three friends. He's just sitting there in a little notebook drawing tiny swastikas.
That one
poop
swastika that started Black Lives Matter, that started Milo, that started fucking
Blue Lives,
fucking Jones or Alex Jones. It started his rise to fucking prominence, dude. That started so much shit.
God damn it, man.
Trump, he fucking
pump got elected. You can Trump fucking got go elected
back off the poop swastika, dude.
Dude, that started everything.
That's that fucking poop swastika at in Missouri. I heard everything kicked off.
This is a rumor, but I heard they like analyzed like the like the molecular level of the poop swastika and figured out how to do artificial intelligence. It started everything. Holy fuck.
Yeah, dude, Trump got elected off the backlash of the overreaction of the poop swastika.
Oh my God.
I mean, this is like a butterfly flaps his wings and starts a tsunami.
Ashton Kutcher blinks and wakes up in another life.
Yeah, Ashton Kutcher was the one who fucking did it.
He has no legs now. He's like, whoa.
He's like, what happened? Oh, shit swastika. Oh. All right, we should probably call it, dude.
We're out of here.
You guys, August 11th.
Come out.
If you don't come to the show August 11th.
I'm going
to
smear another one.
We're going to make a poop swastika at Helium and start God knows what, dude. What do you think, what group do you think would come out of that? I think the Koreans have had enough of this podcast, dude.
You think?
I think fucking Yellow Lives Matter would pop right up.
Oh, my God. We've been quiet on that, quiet on those boys for a while.
Our lives are very matter.
We'll pick up the slack on them.
Yeah, we have been fucking taking it easy on the Koreans.
Yeah, they're still fucking, you know, they're still testing out their missiles, around, dude. They buy all their missiles from where the Roadrunner buys their shit from.
It comes in an Acme box. Oh, very good box. Yeah.
They light it off and they just have a sign that says, help me, and then you fucking turn to dust.
That's actually how most Koreans die, is sprinting straight off a cliff. And then they look down, they're like, oh, not good. Just a little puff of dust. All right, that's good. All right. So August 11th, Helium Comedy Club live cast, dude. It's going to be fucking lit.
God damn, it's going to be good. Get out there. Farewell.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back with the Les Paul. Shit I smoke is like cholesterol. Spilled dressing on the vest at the festival, the best of all. Had a midget Puerto Rican at my beck and call. Best believe that there was neck involved. Fuck around and almost wrecked the sub. We took acid for 10 days straight up in the mountains. Yeah.